I guess. So my name is Anthony Jones. I've been a developer at Bodybug for just over a year now. I decided to look into ngUpgrade as part of the Angular 2 beta release. So I put together a presentation for you guys. So along with the slideshow, you have a plunker that I worked on. So as I was spinning up a project today, just a hot towel generator.
Can you adjust the mic a little bit?
Sure.
Bill is marginally taller than us.
Does that work?
Yeah, just spin a little, yeah, you're good.
So I spun up a hot towel generator project by John Poppin. I was going to put all this new ngUpgrade stuff in there. About halfway through, I realized UI router does not work with Angular 2 at all.
Oh.
And instead of putting in the new Angular router, which we're supposed to do, I just spun up something real quick on Plunker just to display what I was working on. So on the left here, this is a to-do app. It's an Angular 1 component. On the right is a to-do app. It's Angular 2. So I was able to get the ngUpgrade working on here. Pretty simple, just a couple views for the directives, or well, one directive and then do Angular components. And not too much code if you're not doing anything with routes. So switch over to the slides here. So with the release of Angular 2 beta, we get ngUpgrade. And basically that is an upgrade module that's included in Angular 2. It allows us to mix and match Angular 1 and Angular 2 components in the same application. That means we don't have to upgrade everything at once. So if you have an existing Angular 1 application, you could actually start with your new components being in Angular 2. You don't have to change anything. You can go back and convert those over gradually if you want to, but you also don't have to. So those can't coexist on the same application. So how that works is the upgrade module, it has an upgrade adapter. And so this is actually a service, and it will bootstrap and manage your hybrid application. So when you use the upgrade adapter, it runs both versions of Angular at the same time, which is not the greatest for performance, especially with the beta version of Angular 2 being quite a bit larger than what their enabled is. So they are still separate frameworks. So Angular 2 code runs in the Angular 2 framework, and Angular 2 code runs in the Angular 1. So Angular 1 applications can be bootstrapped in two ways. So one of the most common ways, and this is one that we use quite a bit, is using the ngApp directive within the HTML. You can also call angular.bootstrap inside of your module. So in Angular 2, you can only do the bootstrap. There is no more. So that's also the case when you're making a hybrid app. So the first step to actually upgrading your application is to bootstrap it as a hybrid so that you can support both one and two. So over in the index.html, before we would have had the ngApp and then the name of your app module. And we just take that out. So, and in the body, when you're done with it, you would actually just have a new Angular 2 component. So you would just plug that right into your HTML. So now, you would add, once removing the ng-app, you would add the Angular bootstrap method. So this is just a little example of how you would do that. So you take your existing module, and just bootstrap that once the document's ready. So once you've done this, your app should work exactly the same as it was before. So the next step is to install Angular 2. Now, I'm not going to go through the entire process of that, but if you look at the Angular 2 docs, there's a quick start page, and it tells you everything you need to know about starting an Angular 2 project. So this was actually my first Angular 2 project, so I didn't build anything too complicated. I did get into some of the new directives and the new syntax, which was pretty cool. I decided just for the Plunker version to stick with ES5. I didn't want to get into TypeScript or ES6 or ES15. So once we have the Angular 2 installed, we can import and instantiate upgrade adapter and then bootstrap through the adapter rather than the native. So it actually takes the same arguments as the So back in here, this was our old module, and we're using the Angular Bootstrap. We would actually take that out. In ES5, you would just assign a variable. In TypeScript, or ES2015, you would import the upgrade adapter. Then you have your module, that doesn't change, and then the adapter does the bootstrapping. So at this point, your app is a hybrid, and it's running both Angular 1 and 2. So let's see. Angular 2 needs a component with a reference to the directives that it uses. So this is an Angular 2 component in ES5. So off of the ng core, you would build your component. You have your selector. So whereas with the directive in Angular 1, you basically have your name and it's camel cases. The name, you actually pick what your directive tag is going to be. That's the selector. And then the template, this is actually an Angular 1 component, your directive right here. And then this is the Angular 2 component. So that's the template. You can do a template URL if you want. Small project, just plug it in the template. So, and then there's another part here where we actually include all of the directives that we're going to use within this component. And when you're using an Angular 1 directive inside of the Angular 2 component, you actually want to bring back that adapter and use the upgrade ng1 component method on there. And then you just plug in your Angular 1. Be available to your Angular 2 component. And then Vue 2 is an Angular 2 component. And you've got your class instead of the controller, the Angular 2 component as a class. I don't really have this one doing anything since it just basically uses the other directive component there. And then the last thing that you want to do there is actually downgrade the app component so that it can be used within the Angular 1 project. So you basically turn it into an Angular 1 directive. So you've got your module here, and you make this new directive, the adapter dot downgrade ng2 component, you plug in your Angular 2 component. And there you go. So the research that I did to put this together was heavily influenced by the Angular 2 docs. They had an entire page on upgrading from 1 to 2. And there's also this thoughtram.io article that I looked at. It has a lot of good examples on there. So back to the directive here. So right here you can see the actual Angular legacy module here, and then we're building the Angular one directive on top of that. So that has everything that you'd expect from an Angular one directive. So everything that you would expect from an Angular one directive. We've got the template URL too. And, the actual. No, I can't zoom in. So that just points over here. And I'm using controller as syntax, so I've got VN here. Objects and functions there. And then in two, so we have a little bit different syntax. Instead of the ngup, you have ng4, ngif, you just wrap in parentheses there. Pretty similar for ngclass, ngmodel binding, so you wrap that in the brackets there. Any questions?
Is this the official Angular team, or has somebody else developed it? Is it from the official Angular team? Is it part of Angular core, or is it something somebody else has developed and the Angular team supporting it?
So ngUpgrade is included in the Angular team.
It ships with it.
Yes.
So what's the difference between this and is it ng forward?
So the difference between ngUpgrade and ngForward, I believe ngForward you're actually converting everything over to Angular 2, while with ngUpgrade you can run both at the same time.
It's, I think ngForward emulates and is able to translate your ngForward code into your G2 stuff.
Have an existing app that's pretty large and don't really want to go through the process of upgrading everything all at once. This might be better. If you just started a project, you might be better off doing it. Any questions?
Did you find any gotchas? Any big issues with it? Read about any?
The UI router stuff is surprising me. I've been so used to using that over the last year, I've really gotten away from the UI router.
Could you speak into the mic?
What's that?
Mic.
Microphone.
Oh, sorry. I forgot that I was talking to a crowd. So I just got so used to using UI router over the past year, and really the solution right now is to use the new Angular router. So, and from what I can see, it looks pretty straightforward. It's a component router, so it's a little more simple than what the old Angular router was. Thanks, guys.